In this video, I'll show you how I animated my YouTube intro and After Effects. Hi, my name is Manuel. I'm a freelance motion designer, bringing you fresh animation and motion graphics tutorials every week. I think a YouTube intro shouldn't be any longer than 5 seconds. It is basically a logo reveal. As my logo has a round shape, I wanted to use round shapes as main elements throughout the intro. Let's dive into the basic setup. Taking some of the footage away, you can see the plain shapes behind. That's the shape animation without any footage or other details. The top three shapes at the beginning are opening up the intro. Below them, we see parts of circular shapes in different colors moving around the center point of the screen. Let's animate some of these shapes. We add a solid to our comp, a bright red color. In this case, I use 1920 by 1920 pixels as size, because if you double click on the ellipse tool now, a perfectly round mask is created. Let's open the path property and subtract the mask. By changing the mask expansion, we control the size of the hole in the middle. Let's set it to -560. To cut out a slice of the round shape, we add a radial wipe. Set the transition completion to 4% and the start angle to -210 degrees. Set keyframes for each, press U to see the keyframes in the timeline, then we move to, let's say, 100 frames and set the transition completion to 40% and the start angle to -110 degrees. Next, let's select the keyframes and open the graph editor. Make sure the snap icon is activated and edit speed graph is selected to adjust the speed curve. We want a pretty fast start and then a very smooth end. That's also the overall speed of the intro, a fast start and slowing down with the logo reveal. Awesome. Now we need to add some depth by using a drop shadow. Let's set the opacity to 50%, the direction to 135, the softness to 540. That's a very soft shadow, so let's add another one. Set the opacity to 40%, the distance to 0, and the softness to 40. I always use at least two drop shadows, a very soft one that spreads out, and a harder one that's close to the edge. Let's add another shape on top. We add a new yellow solid, same big size, and add two masks this time. We subtract the first one and intersect the second one. Let's set the mask expansion of the first one to -440. And of the second one to -260 pixels. Let's add a radial wipe. Set keyframes for the transition completion and the start angle. Set the first one to 93%, the start angle to 230 degrees. Then we go to 100 frames and set the transition completion to 40% and the start angle to 90 degrees. We quickly adjust the speed curves, which are flipped this time because the yellow shape is moving in the opposite direction. Finally, we copy and paste the two drop shadows. Now to the shapes at the beginning. Let's add another solid, a round mask subtracted. Set the mask expansion to around -990 so that the hole completely disappears. Then we add a radial wipe. Set the transition completion to 50%, the start angle to around 150 degrees, and copy and paste the two drop shadows. Let's set keyframes for the mask expansion, transition completion, and start angle. Then we go to 24 frames and set the mask expansion to around 445 pixels so that the shape completely disappears. The transition completion to 100. And the start angle to 217 degrees. Let's select all the keyframes and adjust the speed curve. We want the animation to start slowly and move out of the screen very fast. I thought just plain shapes would be boring, so I started to add footage on top of some of them. I duplicated the shape I wanted the footage to be on, deleted the drop shadow, and changed the color to white. Then added the footage below the white shape and turned it into an alpha mask. I think altogether it took me around 3 days to come up with the idea and to create and animate this whole intro. Finally, I added this little text animation for which I converted text into paths and animated the letters basically frame by frame. I added a quick logo reveal, and all these little detail graphic elements, like circular strokes and crosses. One last thing. Here's a simple way to create an X or cross. Double-click on the Start tool. Set points to 4 and the inner radius to 0. That's it. Timing is very important for intros. In my case, there are 2 frames interrupting the beginning of my videos, then the intro takes up speed very fast and with the logo reveal it slows down again and smooths out. On the left side I've added some videos you might like, so see you there. Subscribe to my channel on the right side and ring the bell if you want to know exactly when the next video is coming out. Thanks so much for watching, hope that tutorial was useful for y'all. See you in the next video, bye!